Vikings, their offense ready to go, first and 10. On first and 10, Moon. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Johnson. And it's a big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground at the 41-yard line. Second down now after the pass completion. Now the first carry for Brandon Oliver. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. He got 29 yards that time.
Well, I mean to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, a nice big play there.
Three plays, three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, okay, we've got a matchup we like coming right out of the gate. Let's go ahead and get right to it.
And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
And a strange one here, a little befuddled. They're sending out the field goal unit now. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And the 39-year-old veteran puts it right through. And the opening drive of the game yields 3. And the first 3 points of the night belong to our home team as they get the field goal on the game's initial drive.
A good, solid drive. It didn't wind up in the end zone, but that's okay. You've got something positive on the board, and you got the early lead.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The first carry down for Rob Kelly. Space to maneuver at the 40, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets them a new set of downs.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes really good tight end.
On first and 10, Cousins. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break. Don't forget, coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Larry Ridley. Larry will have the highlights of this first half, but he won't have touchdowns because we haven't had any to this point.
But there's still time, though, partner.
And he'll get inside the 40 to maybe the 38-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
From the gun, here's Cousins. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that past the sticks, first down.
So on fourth down, the Redskins will call on Tressway to punt it away. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback.
Now this offense ready to head back out there. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done. In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
They run. It's Oliver. And 5 yards on the play there. It's a drive will continue. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Throwing on first down, Moon, over the middle, complete. That's Johnson, and he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. 23 yards on the play.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. A good pickup there, 22. On first down, Moon. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Terrell McClain in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Looking to throw on second down, Moon. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And Janikowski bangs it through. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. Both teams have played a clean first half, that there are no turnovers to this point. That being the case, it's no surprise that we have a very close game at halftime. All right, let's do this. Here's the first half highlights. First and 10. Moon's got the completion from the gun, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 43-yard line. So that's it for us. We'll go back now to Chicago for the start of the second half.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Starts with Rob Kelly. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, that play typifies what we've seen from the offense all day long. They've had no success getting things going. I think for the offensive coordinator, he's got to go to that side of the play sheet that says, try something.
And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Brian Cushing in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop it for a loss of about 10. Well, there was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Derek Morgan, he's the one to get him this time. And back-to-back sacks are going to bring up a 4.
Now, this is where field awareness comes into play. He's getting perilously close to his own goal line, and after that sack, backed up to his own 2.
Here's Tressway now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
We got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
On first and 10, Moon got his man complete over the middle. It's Johnson. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And quickly, they get to the line. To throw on second down. Moon. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal. From the gun, Moon. And this is going to be intercepted. Sua Cravens with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football. Back now at Soldier Field. It's the Redskins with the football, but trailing here as we get down to the good stuff. Quarter number 4. Following the interception, Cousins. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Throwing his Cousins. Pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line.
Well, it's apparent that these guys are getting after it right from the opening kickoff. They roll right downfield and score on their first possession. And here on defense, back-to-back sacks. Someone is ready to play.
Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a 3rd and long. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So it's Redskin football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Third and long for Cousins. That's complete to Brian Quick. And oh, at the end of it, he's stripped. Ball comes loose. And the defense says they have it. Yes, they've got it.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
Following the fumble recovery, Moon. And his throw here is incomplete.
And it is true, you can draft the fastest, you can draft the most athletic guys, but if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, he'll force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. He can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. So it's third and long, and defensively, not a real surprise there in the dime.
Here we go.
Looking to throw. Moon. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. On the return that time, and it'll be Redskins football now with a first and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. They're down here in a one-score game. I'm at the time. It's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. He'll look to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Brian Quick, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown out of his reach and incomplete. Back to throw. This one complete to Jordan Reed. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Cousins to his big target. Reed and the Redskins have a first down. Back to throw. He'll leave it for Kelly, complete. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it second down.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one. Got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. They may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
He's got Quick. So offside's the call, and they understandably decline it.
And this is why we're seeing more and more teams hiring that one coach to the staff that's in charge of all these things. This one's minor. It's pretty easy to figure out. But all the game management stuff, trying to help out the head coach in his decision-making process.
And he finds the tight end, Reed, and taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Still needing 10 yards, second down. They'll look to throw. Pass incomplete.
When we talk with people about what we think the most important quality for an NFL quarterback to possess, what do people usually say?
Arm strength. And he showed the arm strength there.
Yeah, pretty good bullet pass he threw, but he wasn't accurate, was he?
No.
Listen, you like mobility, but accuracy, first and foremost.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Derek Morgan in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. He's back to throw. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. So a tough pill to swallow there. A would-be touchdown pass in and out of his hands on fourth.
Sometimes it just comes down to execution, doesn't it? Because we're always questioning, should they go for it, should they not? Is it the right play call? Is it not? In this situation, everything was right except for the finish. You have to catch the ball and convert.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there, second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe to get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college, and how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt.
Rather you than me. If you've been with me from Port of Miami,